Curves can now be trimmed or extended with the new Trim Curve feature. Simply select Trim Curve from the toolbar, choose whether to trim or extend, and select your curve. When trimming a curve, you first define the boundary that you want to trim by selecting the geometry from the graphics. Then you can define a help point, which is simply a reference point for which end of the curve that you want to keep. When extending a curve, you have end condition options of either blind or up to entity, extension options for either tangent or curvature continuous, and like trim, the ability to define a help point. In this situation, the help point defines which end of the curve is to be extended. Using the up to entity end condition, you can select other curves, faces, edges, even make connectors to define your extension. Variables are now supported for instance counts in sketch patterns. This makes sketch patterns more intelligent and means you can use sketch patterns in situations where in the past your only option might have been a feature pattern. You can now edit metadata associated with standard content in Onshape. In the past, this was limited to part number and description, but with this update, while inserting standard content, you will see a new icon to edit the properties. This will bring up the same properties dialog that you use throughout Onshape, and you now have the ability to edit all metadata associated with your standard content. As always, any changes made to standard content are instantly reflected throughout your company. Drawing dimensions with bent leaders now have an adjustable jog point, meaning the distance between the dimension and the bend in the leader is now adjustable. Onshape professional and enterprise administrators can now define numbering schemes for more than just released objects. In your company settings, you'll see a new option for numbering schemes. Here, you can define your numbering scheme for not only released objects, but now for standard content and items as well. Simply set the option to sequential number generation, set your numbering scheme, and save the changes. Then, auto-generate part numbers the same way you would for released objects. An entirely new library with over 900 appearances was added to Render Studio Appearance Library with this update. This includes many highly requested metals, paints, plastics, and more.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.